I'm Major Lisa Lori, U.S. Army, certified instructor in aerobics, yoga, and Pilates.
And we're here to get you fit for duty!
A show by the military, for the military, and for anyone else who wants a hardcore workout. Prepare to sweat.
Today on Fit for Duty, core yoga. All you'll need is a mat for this ab and back workout. Welcome to Fit for Duty. I want to thank my workout partners for today, Joseph from the U.S. Air Force Honor Guard and Jordan from the Army G3 at the Pentagon. Let's begin. Beginning in mountain pose, Tadasana, placing the palms in prayer, the feet directly underneath your hips. You can have them close together or a little farther apart, whatever works for you, whatever feels most comfortable. We begin with a small warm-up, Sun Moon series. Inhaling, extending the arms overhead. Exhale, leading with the breastbone into a swan dive, folding forward. Now, if you can easily touch the ground, feel free to do so. But if you have a little trouble, grab some blocks and rest your hands on the blocks. Feeling the lengthening through the backs of the legs, just relax your chest forward over the thighs, lifting the kneecap into the thigh muscle. Inhale and come halfway up into airplane, extending the arms out. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, reverse swan dive. All the way up, stacking one vertebra on top of the other. Palms come into prayer. And exhale, returning to mountain. Inhale, lifting upward. Exhale, swan dive forward, resting hands to the ground or block. Inhale, halfway up, extend airplane. And exhale, fold. Inhale all the way up, arms lifting overhead to upward salute. And exhale, returning to mountain. One more time, inhaling up, swan diving and folding. Exhaling halfway up, lengthening. Exhale, fold. Inhale all the way up, arms come overhead. And palms to prayer. Moving into sun salutation, inhale up. Exhale and swan dive, leading with that breastbone. Inhale halfway up, lengthen. And exhale, fold. Step the right leg back into a low lunge. As we hold low lunge, you should find that the left knee is directly over the heel and the top of the foot is visible. The weight is rested in your soles of your feet and the hands are just there for a little bit of balance support. Shift your weight into that right ball of the foot and lift the knee to activate the quadricep. Now release, dropping that right knee into the ground, tucking the tailbone under. And lift. And release down. And lift. And on this last one, release to the ground, flatten the top of the right foot to the mat, peeling your chest up, bringing your arms overhead, we come into half warrior. Now, if you find that you're uncomfortable with the pressure that's on the back of your knee, you can always slide a rolled towel or a blanket underneath that back knee. Now draw the palms to chest level in prayer and rotate to the left. Looking over that left shoulder, we hold a twist. Now you could choose to stay here, or if you like, let's take that twist a little deeper, bringing that right elbow over the left thigh and holding. Now maybe you'd like to stay here. You'd like to take it even bigger. Extend the arm. Choose the level that's appropriate for you. Returning palms to prayer. Return to half warrior. Arching the back slightly. Releasing palms to the ground and return to low lunge. Step back to plank pose. The feet about hip width apart, the hands directly under the eye of the shoulder. If you'd like to modify, you can rest your knees on the mat. Engage the abdominals by pulling the belly button to the spine and drawing the rib cage down. Allow the shoulder blades to slide down the back. Now slowly lower to the ground to chaturanga or to a hover. Remember your modification to be to rest the knees to the ground. Now exhale and lift, returning to plank. Release to the ground. Resting everything to the mat, flattening the tops of the feet, we peel up to cobra. Now how high you take your cobra, it's really up to you and what your spinal flexibility will allow. Maybe it's very small, maybe you can pull even higher. Just for today, but keep it a little bit smaller. Releasing the chest to the mat, shift all of your weight back into extended child's pose. Curling the toes under, lift the knees off the mat, and come into downward facing dog. Now, ideally, the heels roll into the mat, but if you find that's not quite for you, you may choose to just bicycle your weight from right foot to left foot. If you could step a little closer onto the mat, and walking the feet in, lifting the tailbone high into the air, and drawing the chest down, lengthening through the spine. You can shift your weight back and forth or keep the knees bent just a little bit. Step your right leg forward. If you need to give that leg a little help, just push gently on the right calf to slide the leg forward. Dropping the left knee to the mat, lift the knee, drop the knee, and lift. And on this last one, we rest the knee, flattening the foot, peeling the chest up, half warrior. Releasing hands to the mat, curling left toes under, lift the knee, pushing into that right foot, we step forward and fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive up, slowly stacking the vertebra, bringing the arms overhead into prayer. And then release, mountain. Let's repeat on the left side. Inhale up, and swan dive fold. Halfway up, exhale fold. Now our left leg steps back. Returning to that low lunge, take a quick second to check your body position, knee forming that 90 degree angle, knee directly over the heel, top of that foot visible. Pushing into the left ball of the foot, lifting the tailbone slightly, and then drop the tailbone, tucking it under. Feeling that energy right there in the hip flexor, and then lift. And again we drop, and we lift. And our last one, we rest that knee to the mat, flatten the foot, peeling our chest up, we return to half warrior. Pushing into that right foot to alleviate any pressure that might be on that back knee. Coming to center, palms to prayer, rotate right, and bring that left elbow over the thigh and hold. If you'd like to take this bigger, extend the arms. Continue to hold here. Now, as you extend the arms, imagine the arms are a natural extension of your shoulders. So you want to bring it straight out of the shoulder joint, not winging back. If you feel any tension across the pecs or right across the chest, it's a sign maybe you're winging that arm back a little bit. So bring it an inch or two forward. And now we bring ourselves back to half warrior. Dropping hands to the ground, curling left toes under, lift the knee, low lunge. Step back to plank or a modified plank. Lower to chaturanga, holding that hover. As we drop into our hover, you want to be focused on the breath, drawing energy from that breath, inhaling deeply. And exhaling. Returning to plank, pushing up. And then releasing all the way to the ground. And lifting to cobra. Exhaling, releasing, and shifting back through extended child's pose. Curling the toes under. Lift the feet or lift the heels. And roll into downward facing dog. Bicycling back and forth if you need to. As we gaze back at our feet, we see that they're no wider than hip width apart and definitely no narrower. So let's step our left foot forward, giving that calf a little help if necessary, returning to that low lunge. Dropping the right knee to the mat, lift it. And again. And lift. And last time, dropping that knee, we peel our chest up, half warrior. Dropping the hands to the mat, curling right toes under, pushing forward into that left leg, we fold. Inhaling, stacking the vertebra, bringing the palms into prayer, and this time coming back into a back extension. Now, if you find that you need a little bit more back support in this position, you can lower your hands and rest them on the buttocks. Go ahead and do that for me. Now, as you hold this back bend, I want you to imagine that there's a strap around your chest and you're being hoisted by that strap. So we're not leading with our hips and belly. We're more leading with our heart and pulling. Releasing to center, exhaling and folding. Inhale all the way up. And exhale to prayer. Since we're now warm, let's take a quick break. And we'll return for a floor series for yoga for abs and back. Welcome back to Fit for Duty Core Yoga. So we begin to move into our seated series. Inhale, lifting arms overhead. Exhale, swan diving forward. And we bend our knees into a nice low squat. Once again, drawing our palms into prayer. Releasing our hands to the mat. Tip back to a seated position and slide the feet out as we slowly roll down into a supine position with bent knee. Make small adjustments to center yourself on the mat. As we lay on our backs, the heels are a little bit distant from our gluteals, soles of the feet are flat, and we're rolling into the balls of the foot and big toe. Drawing the rib cage down, the belly button in to support and protect the lower back. Inhale, we roll up into a small crunch and hold. Now, if you find that you need a little bit more neck support, you can place your hands behind your head. You'd prefer to make it more challenging. Extend the arms along your ears. And now slowly roll down one vertebra at a time. Inhale, breathing up. Exhale, extend the right leg. Knees level with one another. Continue to hold the belly button into the spine and that rib cage down. Now we take the leg, lower it to calf, and then bring it up. Now make small circles with that toe. As you circle the toe, keep the hips very level. There should be no wobbling whatsoever. Now reverse the direction. Return to center, lift the leg skyward to 90 degrees, lower the back, lower the leg, and bend the knee. Left side, peeling the chest up, drawing the belly button into spine, rib cage down, extend the left leg. Arms can be by your side, behind your head, or extended along your ears. Lower to calf level. and lift. And again, and lift. Now as we hold center, draw small circles with your big toe without wobbling the hips. They're very, very small, nice isolated movements. If you find that your hips are wobbling, you can make the lever a little smaller by bending the knee and drawing circles, reverse direction. Return to center, lift the legs skyward, lower the back, and bend the knee, releasing the arms by your side. Drawing the rib cage down, the belly in, bring the knees up over the hips, pointing the toes. Now you can choose to keep your head on the ground, especially if you have some neck issues, or lift the shoulders. As we lower first the right foot, and then bring it up. And then the left foot, and bring it up. And just walking or marching back and forth, tapping gently. If you'd like to increase intensity, extend the leg so it appears more like a slow flutter kick. And now both feet, tapping down and exhaling up. And again, and up. And one more, always keeping the core engaged by pulling that rib cage down. And last one, and then extend the legs out as we hold half boat. Continue to hold. Breathe. Breathe. So you should find that you are beginning to feel that in the abdominals. I think my partners here are. Holding there, extending and lengthening. And now let's hug those knees into the chest for a quick break. And then lower the feet to the floor and extend the legs. Now the next movement is moving into a full boat pose. It's a little more advanced, so if you choose, you can start from a bent knee position instead. Otherwise, both legs extend. We inhale and bring the arms up to shoulder level. As we exhale, we pull the rib cage in, peeling up and lifting the legs and holding. Spiraling the thighs in, turning the feet out, we hold boat. Now if you like, you can modify by bending the knees, and we want to bring that back all the way up off the ground, tipping and lifting and lifting and lifting. The shoulders come back, the rib cage comes down. If you find that your back begins to round or sink, that's a sign that maybe you want to modify a little bit. So we want to bring the breastbone forward and hold for 5 breaths, 4, 3, 2, and 1, hugging the knees in, releasing back. Now turning the spine the opposite direction for a small back bend, bridge pose. Soles of the feet rest on the ground, heels under the knees. Arms relax by your side as we begin to peel one vertebra at a time away from the mat and rounding the spine. As you lift, the weight begins to shift toward the top edge of your shoulders. As we lift, the belly is soft. This is one of the few occasions in life where you can just let your tummy hang out. So just go ahead and let it go. Now, if you find that you prefer a little more back support, placing your hands under the buttocks is fine. Otherwise, you can hold yourself up. If you'd like to make that even bigger, interlace the fingers underneath you and pull the shoulders deeper. The soles of the feet are flat to the earth, the thighs parallel to one another. So rolling the thighs in, knees in line with the hip. Inhaling and exhaling. Holding that lift, once again imagining that you're being hoisted by the rib cage upward.
If you'd like to make it even bigger and can reach your heels, go ahead. And now slowly release down and hug the knees into the chest. Bringing the knees to center, draw the knees off to the right side and extend the left arm for spinal twist. The thighs are distant from the abdomen, and both shoulders are anchored to the mat. Turn the gaze to look over the left arm. Creating a lot of distance between rib cage and hip bone, just sink the hip in opposition of the bent legs. Now as we inhale, we pull the belly in and lift the knees skyward. And then exhale and drop the knees to the left. And turn the gaze over the right. Bringing knees back to center, we inhale and pull the belly in. And then hug the knees into the chest as we rock and roll up to seated and swing the legs behind us to lie on our abdomen. Keeping the face toward the ground, extend the arms in front of you. Inhale and lift the right arm and left leg, peeling the chest up. Resist the temptation to use your left arm to push you out of the earth. Back strength is lifting you away from the ground. Both hips are anchored to the mat, and we release. And then the left arm and right leg lift, and we hold. Challenging it a little more, you can lift that right hand off the mat. And release. Keeping both legs anchored, lift only the arms, coming up as high as you're comfortable. Rolling the thighs in, tightening through the gluteals. We lift, keeping those feet anchored, and then lower down. Arms and chest relax. Now the reverse, inhaling, and as we exhale, the feet lift skyward, peeling up, continuing to work the back, keeping the chest down, keeping the neck in alignment, looking out in front of you at the ground. Continue to hold, continue to tighten the gluteals, rolling the thighs in, lengthen and breathe. Inhale and release. And now we shift our weight back, placing hands under the shoulders, child's pose. And round the back, pulling the knee, thighs up, and the chest away from the leg. And we round into rabbit pose. Release down. And slowly roll up, one vertebra at a time, to kneeling. As we inhale up. And exhale, palms to prayer. This completes yoga for core strengthening. Namaste.
Hello, I'm Commander Dave Kevlish, orthopedic surgeon and team physician at the U.S. Naval Academy. Today's topic is crunches versus regular sit-ups. Which one's better? I guess I'm old school. Most modern fitness gurus and personal trainers will spout a bunch of reasons why the crunch is superior to the old-fashioned sit-up. Many experts regard the crunch as superior because, supposedly, it isolates the abs better and it's supposed to be kinder and gentler to your low back. Somehow it seems that the abdominal crunch has become this sacred cow exercise that no one dare criticize. But I respectfully disagree with the experts on this one, and I prefer the old-fashioned sit-up over crunches. Here's why. Your neck and back are going to be fine. If you just take it slow and use good technique, I mean, don't be a spaz. Honestly, think about how much more pressure is on your low back when you're bending over and standing lifting up something than when you're doing a crunch or a sit-up. Number two, target muscles must always be isolated for any lift to be successful. This has to be a given, and it's largely a mental focus kind of thing. Stay focused and you can isolate your abs just as effectively doing sit-ups as you can with crunches. After all, crunches don't guarantee anything unless they're done properly. I've seen plenty of folks in the gym doing some sort of worthless quivering motion on the floor, and they think they're doing good crunches. They're not. In fact, I feel that the variety of combinations you can get doing regular sit-ups or incline sit-ups lets you isolate more muscle groups more specifically and better than crunches ever could. Working a muscle through a full range of motion is better for developing strength and explosive power as well, plus it burns more calories. Please, don't get me wrong. Not that I dislike crunches, as much as I just think old-fashioned sit-ups have gotten a bad rap in recent years. If you're getting the results you're looking for by doing crunches, then by all means, keep doing them. Together, let's train smart and stay strong.
I hope you enjoyed your core strengthening yoga workout. I'd like to once again thank my partners from the U.S. Air Force Honor Guard, Joseph, and from Army G3 at the Pentagon, Jordan. And I'll see you next time on Fit for Duty.